Hello everybody, this is ManuS and welcome to another Eternal Essentials video. Okay, so today I got something a little different for you guys. I have thought quite some time about this topic lately and also observed and kind of investigated the impact of it. And what I want to talk about today is the redraw rule. The redraw rule as it has been changed a couple of months ago. So the way it works now is your first opening hand chops off all hands that have 0 power and 7 power and basically reshuffles those till it gets a hand that has 1 to 6 power. And then if you redraw, you gain a hand that has 2 to 4 power, but the probability of whether you gain 2, 3, or 4 power is evenly distributed no matter which deck. So no matter how much power you play, you always have a 33% chance to get 2, 3, or 4 power. So on average you get 3. But yeah, it's only an average. The fact that you actually can get 2 and 4 rather than always 3 is a big difference, obviously. They did this when they made that change. Remember, the old redraw rule used to be you redraw into a hand that has anywhere from 2 to 5 power. So basically the same way the first hand works now with the 1 to 6, except that it also chops off the 1 power and 6 power hands to further reduce variance. But the probabilities are not forced like they are now. They were not forced. They were just the normal probabilities that your deck had of hitting these hands. They were like slightly inflated by cutting out the other hands, because they would have just been redrawn until it hits 2, 3, 4, or 5 power. But aside from being slightly inflated to normal, due to basically the range of 2 to 5 becoming the full 100% of possibilities rather than only, like, I don't know what the actual probabilities for 0, 1, 6, and 7 power are in an average deck or whatever, but let's say, I don't know, 80 to 90% maybe would be a normal probability to have 2 to 5 power, and with that change it's 100%, so the percentages for all outcomes go up a bunch. But that's all it was. So there was as little probability manipulation as possible, which I actually like, because the thing is, if you mess with variance, mess with probabilities, and artificially manipulate them, that has an uneven impact on decks and on situations, and always is kind of a two-edged sword, because it has positive effects but also negative ones. And that's what I want to talk about. So the problem right now that I see with the redraw as it is the following. First of all, it sort of nullifies some deck building decisions. Like, no matter if you build your deck optimally in terms of power count and influence count, the redraw compensates a lot for your wrongdoing, which is something that shouldn't happen, because that's another way of gaining an edge usually in these kinds of games, building your deck better. And if you gain less from having your deck built more optimally and more mathematically sound than your opponent, and not being rewarded for it, seems wrong to me and kind of frustrating. As you all know, well know, I work a lot on power bases and power base math, and have also postulated proper and conservative amounts of power and influence in your deck to make it consistently work. So the situation the redraw system created is that even if you put insufficient amounts of power and influence in your deck will work more often than it should. The problem is, it will still not work as if work in general as if it had the right amount of power. This leads me back a bit to the discussion with Ilya and his post and stuff. While I basically don't agree with his general stance and view and perception and even suggestions on things, I think I actually agree to some extent on the core idea of the game right now having a bit frustrating high amount of variance and a bit more variance than is healthy. Like, the game feels more coin flippy and variance prone and out of the hand of the player than, say, Magic the Gathering in comparison. Simply because the games feel like they are a bit more decided by Flood and Screw, and I think actually that the especially by Screw, I think the main reason that I found for this, in my opinion, I mean, it's a theory, I'm not 100% sure like how correct and sound everything is that I came up with, but that's why I'm putting it out here for people to discuss, is the redraw system. Since the redraw system, as we have it right now, creates sort of a weird scenario where you have a lose-lose situation. You cannot be right. Like, I think, theoretically, what I propagate, what I postulate about power bases is right, because it's based on sound hypergeometric metrical calculations for your, especially for your first opening hand, for your non-variance manipulated, non-forced hand. The problem is that the math for the redraw hand is very different. And the problem is, you cannot build your deck to be right for both hands. If you get what I mean. The problem is, you can either build your deck properly for the redraw or properly for the first hand. Either way, your deck is gonna operate suboptimally under one of the two circumstances a lot of the time. And even if you build it more focused on the redraw, your deck still is gonna malfunction more often than if you build it properly for your first opening hand. The problem is the following, though. So basically, if I build my deck properly for the first opening hand, so that it works properly under both circumstances, I get kind of more punished by the redraw, because suddenly I'm more likely to flood out, especially on the redraw, and that's one punishment, but that punishment I think is not even that severe, because if your deck needs a lot of power, you probably still don't flood out too much more from the redraw. The punishment is more indirect from the fact that people that build their deck wrong suboptimally in terms of power don't get punished enough and often enough. Like, if you look at it, right now we have this Burn Queen list that won the last four tournaments with a ridiculous amount of 28 power while playing 7 4 drops and 7 5 drops. I encourage everyone to go ahead, pull up a hypergeometric calculator and check the probabilities for this deck hitting 4 and 5 power in a lot of scenarios. And you will see that the percentages are kind of scary in a lot of scenarios, and the deck has a pretty high probability of just not functioning properly. And the deck basically cannot function on 3 power. Like, on 4 it can do pretty well, but still might have a bunch of dead cards in hand, and is limited to like one player turn, which is not a good thing for an aggro deck most of the time. And on 3 it's basically dead. Like, for example, if you look at the ETS 2 weeks ago that Unearthly won, he lost two games being stuck on three. He still ended up winning the finals because he won three other games. But the thing is, in two decks, his deck basically mainly lost due to malfunction. And do we really want to live in a world like this? Do we want to live in a world where we have to build greedy, dysfunctional piles to flip a coin on our redraw and hope to get there? Is this the way the game should be played? I honestly don't think so. Like, the game has enough variance. The game still has its natural flood and screw variance, its variance of the draw of getting your curve and your answers and your threats right and stuff. This is all variance that I'm totally fine with, and it's like a natural part of the game. But what I don't like is basically how this redraw will sort of messes with the laws of nature of these games, basically the laws of variance, the laws of statistics, because it messes with the probabilities and statistics of the game and of these decks, and how kind of linear they normally work. Like, normally if you adjust something in your deck, it ripples through all your probabilities. If you add a power, it positively and or negatively affects all scenarios in a constant manner. But right now, we can make changes to our deck, and they only affect a part of the game, because they don't affect the redraw. And the other thing is, if you build your deck to rely on the redraw more, you take away a lot of decision making, because first of all, you will have a lot more first hands that are unkeepable, unplayable. So you drastically increase your general probability to having to redraw. And then the other thing is, your redraw is final. Like, if your redraw is like 4 power and a bad curve, you're stuck with it. And you have to play it. Which is why the percentage of redrawing, of having to redraw, should be as low as possible to only give you that second chance, that redo on your bad hands, to have a shot at turning some percentage of, like, say 80% of your hands maybe are keepable or whatever, just a made up number. 80% of your hands are keepable, 20% are not. And then let's say the redraw gives you another like 80 or 90% chance of having a reasonable opening hand. Suddenly, we are talking 10. Suddenly, we are talking 96 to 98% functional hands to play a game with. So only 2 to 4% non-games. Keep in mind, these percentages just made up. I don't know any actual percentages on that. It's just an idea to give, just something to give you an idea of how it works. But if you suddenly redraw a much higher percentage, and your overall percentage of playable hands that gives you proper games goes significantly down. So that basically heavily relying on your redraw and too aggressively redrawing creates more non-games. And that's kind of the variance that we have right now. There's a lot of games where people just flipping coins with their dysfunctional power bases and hoping to get there. And that's why we see so many games decided by flood and screw, because there's some people that run sufficient or even conservatively high power amounts, and then redraw into like that 4 power opening hand 33% of the time, and flood out too much, and especially flood out too much against an opponent that's skimping on their power base and high rolling on their redraw to get their 3 or 4 power opening hand, and drawing like their 5th power off the top, and then stopping at like 5 power or 6 power, because their deck has so little power that they are not even likely to hit 5 or 6 power in the first place. But since the redraw gave them 4 to start with, they artificially inflated their probability of hitting 5 or 6, because normally maybe their chance to have like a 4-power opening hand would be 10% and not 33%, and make it much less likely to actually have 5 or 6 power, or even 4 power. So yeah, this creates like a lot of coin flipping. I think it has a very bad impact on deck building. We see lots of dysfunctional power bases that still kind of work and kind of get there, while creating a bunch of non-games on a bunch more non-games on the way there than normally should be the case, because of how sort of generous and universal the redraw is, and them not being properly punished for the choices they make. If you choose to go greedy on your power base, you should be punished by your draws and your probabilities proportional to that. And the redraw gimps and reduces the proportionality of that. While someone that builds their deck properly and has sufficient power to for the deck to work in all scenarios gets slightly punished by an increased probability, by a slightly inflated probability of flooding compared to normally, since obviously a higher power count already has a higher probability of flooding, but usually in a way that is still fine. But if you add the inflated probability of occasionally flooding more than your normal probability due to the redraw, we get a pretty odd scenario where people running poorly built power bases get rewarded more even than the people, while the people that run proper power bases get slightly punished on top of it. So in the end, you cannot be right. You have the choice between either playing these skimpy poor power bases, have a bunch more non-games where you just kind of flip the coin, lose your coin flip, get stuck on 2 or 3 with your 6 to 7, 5 plus drop aggro deck on 25 to 28 power, and just lose without being able to play a game, or you play a proper amount of power and have a bunch of games where you just high roll, flood out while your aggro opponent with their 25 power base hits their 5 or 6 power to play all their 5 drops, ultimate their Pyronite, and just runs you over. That's, among others, exactly what happened to me in the last ETS. I played against a Skycrack deck that had a ridiculous power base. It was 25 power with 2 monuments and 6 5 drops in 25 power. He had 4 Obliterate and 2 Drakes. I mean, do the math on that. Like, running 2 monuments in that is ridiculous, because the deck is like needs to hit 6 power for the monument to actually be more than a depleted sigil. And the deck is not even likely to hit 4 all the time, let alone 5. But what he did against me is, thanks to the redraw and high rolling, he just hit 5 to 7 power against me every game, the 6 and 7's power near the end, when it didn't matter much anymore, plus also in the scenarios where it turned on his ultimates. And that's already like pretty absurd to even draw that much power. Like, normally these games go with him drawing 3 to 4 power and having a bunch of blanks in hand and their Pyronites being blanked for the rest of the game, because his deck is not built to play 5 drops or ultimate Pyronite in most scenarios. But yeah, I, in the same scenario with a deck with like 31 power and 4 Initiate of the Sands and 4 Sorrow Board Wrangler, just flooded out without even seeing one of my 4 monuments in my in my 31 power, but 3 of those were 6, so in like 28 actual power. So I actually have a pretty decent chance to hit a monument even on the redraw in my opening hand as one of my regular power cards. And these things are just very, very frustrating. Like, if you look at the math for both decks, my deck has a much higher probability to function probably based on calculations, while his deck should malfunction most of the time, but the redraw mechanic offsets that. Like, his deck artificially gets a much higher percentage to properly hit the cards that he shouldn't even have in his deck, and I get a slightly higher malfunctioning probability. But the problem is, not even these effects are also not strong enough to make it clear that you either that it's either right to run these skimpy power bases, nor that it is right to run like the mathematical sound power bases. And there seems to be like no, at least from what I looked into and tried and stuff, no real sweet spot in between, because the 28 power in that Stone Scar deck still are not a sweet spot. Like, the deck still feels miserable and super power short and gets stuck on power all the time. I play decks like this. This deck starts feeling reasonable on 30 to 31 power, at least. Like, 31 power. I mean, this deck used to run 31 power. Like, look at Kampfkröte's old list. It had, like, only 4 or 5 drops, not even 7. And it had Flame Blast, which could be a 5-plus drop, but didn't have to be. And the deck still had 31 power. He had 25 plus 6 favors, for example, which is even a bit more than 31 power, because the favors are not counted for your power, so you can get, like, a 3-power opening hand plus a favor, for example. So the deck has a bit more than 31 actual powers, at least on a redraw. So the situation we are in right now, that you can basically not be right, in from my impression and my opinion. Like, the thing that I do with like proper power base math does not fully work and has some minor punishment to it, both from the, I think, slightly increased flood probability, like slightly inflated flood probability, as well as from not being able to punish people as often for skimping on their power bases, because their deck will function more often than it should. And if I am a bit more flooded and a bit lighter on action due to having the right amount of power in my deck, I can punish my opponent for having a bad power base if they get stuck on too low amounts of power, and then I can easily win with the fewer action that I have. But if they are not stuck as often, they will it will create a lot of these scenarios where the screw beats the flood. Like, we all know that, like, if the screw is not too extreme and ends soon enough, while the flood is too extreme and especially increases out back, the screw always wins. And we have a lot of these scenarios now, and those created by and inflated by the redraw system. So I would really be curious to hear from Direwolf what their stats are on the redraw scenarios since they changed it compared to before. Like, for example, has the percentage of redraws increased? Like, what's the probability of people using the redraw before the change, and what's the probability of people redrawing after the change? Because one of their arguments was they made that change to make the redraw more of a decision, because the second hand is structurally much different from the first hand, rather than just the same hand with reduced variance, with the variance extremes chopped off. So that would be really interesting. I would bet that the redraw probability, the percentage of redraws has went up significantly since then. Another thing is the problem that I have is with these forced percentages. It's uneven, since it affects archetypes and decks in different ways. Normally, you have variance and probabilities, and it affects all decks, all archetypes within themselves, the way you build them. Like, if you build a deck with 25 power, you have according probabilities for... Sorry for that. You have probabilities accordingly for all possible outcomes. Like, for example, simple example, chopping off the 0 power and 7 power opening hand options for all decks does not affect each deck the same. It actually affects decks more, the less power they run. Like, for example, if you run 25 power and nothing else, your probability of getting a zero power hand, I did the math with the hypergeometric calculator, is 5%. And I think the probability to get 7 power is 0.02%, so almost non-existent. While, for example, if you look at, say, 33 power hand, something like control decks with like 25 plus 8 or something like that, the probability for getting 7 power, I think, was around 2.2%, and the probability to get 0 power was, I think, below 1%. So I think like 0.2% or something. So, or 0.1. So basically, if you look at the combined percentages, the 25 power deck gets chopped off a bit more than 5% of, like I think 5.1% or something, of its total worth of its total hands, and even a much higher percentage of its worst hands, because the 5.1% are of all hands, and they obviously make off much more than 5.1% of the bad of the hands that you would consider bad if you define a range of, say, any hand that is like 0, 1, 5, 6, and 7 power is a bad hand and automatically something that I would redraw. And then the 0 and 7 power hands make up a significant percentage of those hands. So the percentage of bad hands and the percentage of hands in general is decreased much more drastically, while, for example, the 33 power hand deck, which has a much more reasonable power base, is basically sort of punished by the system, because it only gets less than 2.5% of its total hands chopped off as too bad, as like extreme spikes, because it is built in the first place to overall have much less 0 and 7 power hands combined. Sure, the percentage of getting 7 power hands is 2.2% higher than for the 25 power hand, but it also has almost no more existing 0 power hand probability on the flip side. So basically the 7 power hand goes up by like 2%, but the 0 power hand goes down by almost 5% to almost 0. So the bad power base, the greedy power base, or in some cases the low power deck power base, gets unproportionally more from the redraw system than like from the redraw system than the high power deck, like the slow control, the slow mid-range deck or control deck, or in some cases simply the deck that has the proper amount of power for its curve and its requirements. And I think that's a problem. Like that's what I meant with the solution of artificially and digitally manipulating probabilities. Because normally, if all possible outcomes happen, it can happen, they happen more often or less often based on how you build your deck, based on the choices you make. And chopping off variance extremes benefits different choices and different scenarios unequally. And yeah, I think that just creates a subtle and, in this case, increasing imbalance in the possible choices and deck building. Normally, it's good that it's another upside and side effect of playing more power, because you have to offset the fact that you are more likely to flood if you play more power. And one of the things that offsets the probability, the increased probability of flooding, is the fact that you get much less bad opening hands that you would have to redraw. So your redraw percentage goes way down if you play more power normally. But right now, that's not the case, because the variant spike extremes are chopped off in favor of favoring the greedier build. But the problem is the greedier build does not get consistently better. It just is less bad more often. So you have the choice between either sort of doing the right thing and not getting all the rewards and some punishment for it, or you have the choice to do sort of the wrong and greedy and unstable thing and get less punished than normal, and then you would do by normal variance and probabilities, but still sort of a lot of the time just kind of flip a coin hoping to get there. And that's honestly not something that I'm happy or comfortable with. I don't want to like play a deck that kind of implodes in my hand half the time and loses to itself because I cannot afford to put enough power in it, because there's not enough rewards for it and enough punishment for not doing it. So I'm stuck in a situation where I have to hope my deck works, and a bunch of games just sit there and feel miserable for being stuck on like 3 power with my 4 and my 5 drops in my hand, and accept the fact that that's just the world that we live in, and we just flip coins with our power bases rather than actually are incentivized to make the proper choices and build our power bases on sound math and have like a linear and proportional effect on our choices on our games and on our deck. And that's something that I would like to see and would like to go back to. I honestly don't know what the proper solution would be for the scenario, but I'm pretty sure by now that I'm very unhappy with the situation as it is, especially with the redraw mechanic as it is right now. The chopping of the 0 and 7 power hand is something that I understand and that I think doesn't have that big of an effect. I still dislike that it has an uneven, like unequal effect, and is not linear, not proportional to the amount of power you put in your deck and to the choices, but in a way and in an amount that is livable and overall probably for the better of the game and the games. But for example, going back to the old redraw system would still at least create a lot more incentive to build your power base properly. And keep in mind, if you remember, when they announced the change, one of the things they said was that they still see and feel like people are not playing the proper amount of power, and a fair share of the complaints and bad variants before the change was caused by people building their decks suboptimally and not by the game being flawed in its variants and in its system, or by the 75 cards. But now we are in a situation where there is no good solution, no good fix. Now we cannot really play the right amount of power, because I feel like it's really hard, if there is any at all, to find a proper amount of power to like have this weird balance where your deck works most of the time, but also doesn't get punished too much by people getting lucky on their redraw with skimpy power bases and then out carding you because they draw more business, or even being punished by increased flood. So I would like to go back to a world, to an Eternal, where the choices that we make impact our probabilities in a proportional and linear way and as equal as possible for all scenarios and all archetypes, so that actually kind of tuning and adjusting on the fine-tuning wheel has the proper proper probability impact across all outcomes and kind of tips the scale properly and not just in some cases has like no effect or less effect than it should have because the probabilities are manipulated too much by things like the redraw. Okay, I think that's a whole lot to take in. Let me know what you guys think. I hope this was not too long-winded and good enough to follow. I know it is a complicated and kind of abstract and dry topic, but I hope it's still gonna yield some discussion, because I personally am kind of really unhappy and frustrated right now with this sort of with the situation that feels like kind of a lose-lose situation to me, and that encourages making sort of poor decisions and especially encourages kind of pushing variants, flipping coins, because normally what we want to do in these games, in these variance heavy games, is to try and reduce the variance as much as we can with the decisions that we make, building our decks as consistent and as low variance as we can. And right now the game sort of forces us to sort of push the variance and flip more coins, and I don't think that's a good thing, and it feels kind of poor. All right, that's it for this unusual Eternal Essentials of me discussing the current state of variance and the redraw in the game. Let me know if there's if you think there are some logical fallacies that I have in my theory and in my thoughts, or other things. Just let's have a discussion and see how other people think and feel about this, and let's try to stick to objective and logical arguments rather than subjectivity and complaints, because that's not helping anything or anyone. All right, that's it for this time. Thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time. I'm out. Bye.